had a Boosie fade.
What's wrong with being, what's wrong with being, what's wrong with being confident?
So I want to start off this video by saying why I cut my hair in the first place, because I don't want to tell you guys how I grew my hair off without telling you guys how I, why and how I cut my hair. So this one night, I was feeling a little depressed, a little sad, I was on my sad girl shit, okay? Mind your business. So I was sad, I was mad, depressed. It was so much going on in my life. And I was just like, I was looking in the mirror, and that day I was about to flat iron my hair, but y'all, I looked in the mirror and it made me even more depressed, because first of all, I look like who did it and why, and they don't need to ever do it again, because my hair was ugly. Like, my hair was washed and it was so flimsy and it was so thin, and it was just, at that point, my hair was describing my life. Out of control. That's it. It was out of control. So I took some scissors and I was like, I'm gonna cut my hair into a bob, okay? I was like, boom, let me cut my hair into a bob, let me do it, I'm a stylist. So I started cutting my hair and I was like, snip, 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 snip. And then I was like, I didn't stop. I had no control. I looked up and I was bald. But yeah, that's why I cut my hair. I was in distress. So I took some scissors to my head and I didn't know how to stop. So that's pretty much it to the story. So now let's just get into the video of how I grew it out from them struggle pubes. What it do? It's Vestful. Okay, y'all. So today's video, as you guys can tell by the title, is going to be about how I grew my hair out from being bald-headed to semi-bald-headed. So I just gotta let you guys in on a little tempo on how I did that, because I was the definition, the absolute definition of bald-headed hoe shit, of bald-headed hoe-ish. If there was a club, I'd be the logo. That's really how it was. So I'm just gonna let you guys in on how I got my hair to grow and what I did, what I didn't do, and just, you know, let you guys in on a little tempo. So first things first, I'm gonna start with, since I have braids, I'm gonna start with this one. So number one thing that I use to get my hair to grow is protective styles. Now, when you're like bald headed, like you could rub your head and see your future bald headed, it's kind of hard to, you know, put protective styles in your head. But get you somebody who can grip. Like, if somebody can grip your little testicle hairs you got at the top of your head, use that person. Because when I tell y'all, like, I cut my hair bald, as y'all could tell by, like, the picture that was on the thumbnail, I cut my head extremely bald. So it was hard to do protective styles at first, but my best friend got the hands of Jesus Christ himself. So sis was gripping, y'all. She was gripping. So of course, that's how I grew my hair out, because I used to, like, I do a whole bunch of protective styles. If you see me making videos, half of the times I have braids, I have a wig, I have something on my head that's protecting my hair, because I'm still struggling. Like, I still ain't got it yet. I'm getting there, but I ain't got it yet. But when I got it, just know. When I got it, I got it. All right. So yes, protective styles. Use as many as you can. Get box braids, Fulani braids, get wigs. Like, when you're bald-headed, you can really use wigs. Just put you on a wig cap and let your hair breathe, and it'll grow your hair out a lot. Like, when I first cut my hair, I was wearing wigs a lot, and it gave my hair the chance to grow without being constantly tampered with and constantly bothered. So that was the first thing I used, because protective styles really just, you can't go wrong with protective styles. So I'm gonna say that. Number two, the things that I use a whole bunch of oils. Like, I use growth oils, and if I find them, I'm gonna link them down below. But I use growth oil, I use Jamaican castor oil. Just keep your hair moisturized. No matter what you do, just keep your hair moisturized. Cause at first I wasn't doing nothing with my hair, since it wasn't much scalp, it was just bald. Like, just just little peach fuzz at the top of my hair. I wasn't using that much oils, you feel me? But I was trying this. I was trying, okay? Because let's remember that when y'all try to drag me in the comments. I was trying. But yes, I used a whole bunch of oils. When you have braids in your hair, like for example, these braids that I have in my hair right now, when you have braids in your hair, oil your scalp. Like whatever braids you have, whatever scalp you can see, whatever scalp you can feel, oil it. Use Jamaican castor oil, use growth oil, you use wild growth oil, any oil you could get that you know will work for your hair. Make sure you put that in your scalp because that's like the number one way to grow your hair. Because since your hair is braided under, it's not really much you can really do. But since it is braided under, you can use oils, and oils will grow your hair out like extremely quick. Like oils was my thing. Nah, but oils was my thing, y'all. Like oils is the way to go. If you have oils, you have hair. That's it. That's all. Ain't nothing much to it. You got oils, you got hair. That's it. That's it. You feel me? That's it. It ain't asking much of you. Just put some oil in your hair. So pretty much that's the two things that got me out the bald headed stage. Okay? We're talking about the straight bald headed. I could smack your head. You look like a dumb lollipop head asshole. That's that. Yeah, that gets you out that stage. Okay, now once you're out that stage, it's gonna take a couple months. Like it took me a couple months to even grow my hair to anything like socially acceptable. Y'all, I just had a traumatic flashback. We're just gonna ignore that. But yes, once I grew my hair out to like a little bit of hair, I started using leave-in conditioners. Like I will leave-in conditioner the heck out of my hair. Like anybody knows, I will leave-in conditioner the heck out of my hair. Because at the end of the day, the more you moisturize your hair, the more it will grow. Now, mind you, it took me some trial and errors. Like some leave-in conditioners will flake. Some leave-in conditioners won't even look good. Some of them you'll struggle with. But either way, the more you're trying to do your hair, the more it's gonna work for you. Just it's the trial and error thing. But I do a whole bunch of wash and goes. Once I started getting like a little afro, I would wash my hair and then I put leave-in conditioner, let the curls out just to let it like sit in there, just to let it moisturize my hair as much as it can, because it is hard to keep your hair moisturized, especially because I'm at the time when I was growing my hair out, I was in school, I had a child, and I was working. So it was hard to keep up with my hair. It was hard to maintain my hair. That's why I did a whole bunch of protective styles, because protective styles was really the way to go for me. Like, I'll condition my hair and go about my way. But it's at the end of the day, it's all about how you moisturize your hair. That's like the key to everything. Moisturize your hair. Even when your hair is braided, moisturize your hair. It has wigs on them. And then take off your wig cap, spray your scalp, like spray something, do something to your hair. At the end of the day, as long as you're keeping up with your hair, it's gonna keep up with you, if you know what I mean. As long as you're keeping up with your hair will keep up with you. The fourth thing, I think I'm on number four that I'm gonna try, is pray. Pray, okay? Pray. Pray. That's it. Pray. Because for months, I thought I was gonna die bald-headed. I thought I was gonna die bald headed. I thought like whenever I did my open casket, everybody would just look at me and I would be bald headed. Like that was my fear. I would die bald headed. Like, and that was not the move. So I prayed about it. I asked Jesus. I said, Jesus, please blesseth the scalp you have putteth on my headeth, because I was bald. Okay, I was bald. Like, it wasn't even the cute type of bald, y'all. It wasn't even cute. Like, I feel like it was more like a damn Tupac, you fine type of bald headed. Like, I had a boost pain. Like, but yes, that's gonna be it for the video, guys. I really only use those four methods to grow my hair out, and it's gonna take you a while. It's gonna take you, it just depends. It can take you 2 months, it can take you 7. It just depends on who you are, and you have to have a lot of patience. Growing your hair out takes a lot of patience, because it's sometimes where my hair was like at that like awkward stage where I wanted to cut it back off because it's like I don't want it. But you just gotta be patient with your hair because everybody is different. Some people it takes 3 years to grow their hair out, some people it takes 3 months to grow their hair out. So like I'm saying, just be patient with your hair. Keep your hair moisturized. Keep those protective styles in, ladies. Keep those protective styles in and just work with your hair. Your hair is not going to work with you unless you work with it, okay? Period. But yes, thank you guys for watching this video. And don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Innocent. And I'm going to link that below. And don't forget to follow me on Snapchat at Bessie Innocent.